Are you used to playing fighting games on your PC with a keyboard? Would you like to be able to do the same on your PS5? Let me show you how you can play fighting games like Street Fighter 6 or Tekken 8 on a PS5 with a keyboard using HID Remapper. HID Remapper is a USB adapter that can be used for a lot of things, like reassigning buttons on a mouse or changing keyboard layouts. Among other things, it can pretend to be a PlayStation arcade controller. Its main advantage is that you can then plug any USB device you want into it. It can be another game controller, or in this case a keyboard, and remap the inputs however you like. Here's what we're going to need. An HID remapper. You can either use one with a built-in USB hub like this one, or you can plug an external USB hub into an HID remapper that only has one USB input. Why do we need multiple inputs? It's because in addition to our keyboard, we are going to need to plug in something like this. This is called a Mayflash Magic Boots PS4 V1.1. The reason we need something like this is that a PS5 only likes to work with licensed or authorized peripherals. Using a dongle like this is a way of fooling the PS5 into believing that our HID remapper is a licensed arcade stick. Without it, we would get the infamous 8-minute timeout. There are other devices that can be used for this purpose. Some of them are also dongles, like the Magic Boots. For example, there's the PXN N5. You can also use any licensed PS4 arcade stick from manufacturers like Hori or Quanba or Razer. Okay, as you can see, the keyboard is working fine in Tekken. It's currently using a mapping where the arrows work as the D-pad. The WSD keys work as the left analog stick. The numpad works as the right analog stick, or at least it would if my keyboard had a numpad. And all the action keys are here. But the best part about HID Remapper is that this mapping between keyboard keys and PlayStation controller buttons is not fixed. You can change it to whatever you like. Let me show you how. To configure HID Remapper, I will disconnect it from my PS5 and connect it to my computer. Then I go to this website, which is the configuration website for HID Remapper. You don't have to install any software on your computer, you just go to this website in your browser. Connect to our HID Remapper. Load the configuration that is currently stored on it. And here it is. Here we can see the mapping between keys on the keyboard and what they function as when we connect it to our PS5. For example, we can see that J is cross, K is circle, I is square, and so on. If we want some other key to work as the cross button, all we need to do is click here and choose the key we want. We can also create additional mappings. For example, if you wanted two different keys to both work as the cross button, that's not a problem. You may have noticed that some of these mappings are a bit weird. They have these expressions set out as their inputs. That's because things like the D-pad and the analog sticks have multiple keys as their inputs, so it's not a simple one-to-one mapping. The expressions may look a bit intimidating, but it's not that bad. If all you want to do is make some other set of keys work as the D-pad, then you can just change these codes to the codes for the keys you need. And you can find out what code each key generates by going to the monitor tab and just pressing the key. For example, if I press the arrow keys and then go to the expression responsible for the D-pad, you can see that these are the same codes here. So if you wanted some other keys to work as the D-pad, you just change these. and all the normal action buttons just need simple mappings like these. Oh, and this particular configuration can be found in the Examples tab, along with a lot of other cool uses of HID Remapper. If you're starting fresh, you can just click here to load the configuration, test it, and then maybe modify it to your needs. Okay, if you're interested in this, check out my other video where I explain how you can get your own HID Remapper. Also, take a look at the project's GitHub repository. If you have any questions, please leave a comment. Thanks for watching.